What's up, beautiful people? Woo! Yeah. Anyway, that was good. Got that out of the way. So it's Wednesday. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, and it is my hopes and desire. It is my desire that you are having a great day, an amazing day, and that you are getting all your heart's desire and that everything that you seek is coming your way. So I dub today Wisdom Wednesday. And I did a video on a life coaching group that I'm a part of, and I said, let's just keep it on the surface. Wisdom Wednesday. Also in an app that I'm a part of, Wisdom Wednesday. Let's keep it on the surface and go with what the very definition or the meaning of the word. Because the definition, I'm not sure what it says in the dictionary for wisdom. But let's just go with this. We've all heard before that wisdom is applied knowledge. That's what I want to go with. Wisdom is applied knowledge. Sarah, what's going on? So everybody, it seems like a lot of times these days that everybody is caught up into, and I feel like social media has heightened that a little bit, but everybody is caught up to now letting people know how much you know and showing people how smart you are and all this stuff. And for me, I say, okay, what good is that? How much I know? Now it's time to apply what you know, starting with yourself, and now you have knowledge. I mean, that wisdom, when you apply the knowledge of the things you know to better your life. And guess what? I don't have to tell you what I know and brag on myself and all this stuff. I don't have to tell you what I know and brag on myself and anything like that, because as I show you the wisdom that I exude or the wisdom that you see in my life getting better, you'll ask, right? And that's the thing. I think a lot of times people are so busy worrying about what people see. I want to feel like I'm doing an amazing job. I want to feel like I'm this, I'm that. I want people to think I'm this. No, just apply that knowledge that you have, and then you'll get stronger in your wisdom. Apply knowledge on this Wisdom Wednesday, and then people will see and they'll know. And then they can't deny it, right? Because your life will show it. And yes, knowledge without application is null. Yes, I love that, because that is so true. You can have all the knowledge in the world. You can read all these books and do this and that, and if you ain't applying it, which is that wisdom, then what good are you doing but just reading? Okay, so that's the thing I want you all to think about. And it's a pivotal time that I talk about this, because we're going into a new year. So I know a lot of you are going to set your New Year's resolution. Cool, so be it. I'm not a big fan of them, New Year's resolutions, because I feel that it's almost like the thing we do just because people do it, and it's almost a cop-out to not keeping up with things the whole year. We should be setting daily resolutions and affirmations, monthly, quarterly, not just, oh, it's January, February, oh, I got to get right this and that. But if you do, no problem, because it's, again, still you're at least trying to do something better. You're still doing better, so I'm not knocking it, right? I'm just saying how I feel. So as we begin to approach New Year's, let's keep things on the surface and not make things overcomplicated. In other words, we know a lot of stuff to do. Marvin, what's up, bro? What's going on? Baby Hulk in the house. We know a lot of stuff to do, but we won't do it. Which means we have a lot of knowledge, but we don't have the wisdom to apply that knowledge. Wisdom Wednesday. Let's take it a step further and get past what we know and start thinking about what we do, what we show, applying that knowledge, wisdom. Okay, Mike, I want to lose 10 pounds. And look, I know I got to eat right. I got to get water. I got to get my rest. I got to exercise. Okay, what's the problem, right? So again, it goes from the knowing to wisdom. Hey, look. Man, look, I'm trying to build my credit up, or I'm trying to work on investments and stuff like this, but I know I should probably do some research or maybe see a financial advisor or maybe this and that. So do it again. Wisdom Wednesday, man. Like I say all the time, I want to see everybody win. I want to see everybody win. Why? Because I know that there's enough out here for us all, for all of us to win, for all of us to grow, to shine, to thrive. Not just make it, but to thrive. We can do more than enough. We can do more than what we think we can. We are bigger and better than what we think we are. So again, wisdom, wisdom, let's start applying that knowledge. Everything you've learned, all the life experiences, if you're 15, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 years old, you have a lot of life experiences and knowledge. It's just now, let's make it, turn it into wisdom. Let's apply the things we know. Let's apply the setbacks. Let's apply the breaks from the norm or our routine. Let's apply all that stuff to where we are and where we're going. And now we have true wisdom and we can grow and we can share and people see it, and you attract more people to it because they see that wisdom. They see, oh yeah, Mike, he's not only saying it, but he's doing it. He's applying it. And that's what it's all about, right? I tell people all the time, the most selfless thing you can do is be selfish. You have to love yourself. You have to make yourself whole before you can help someone else. How can you teach somebody about accountability, but you don't have any accountability? How can you teach somebody about being whole when you're broken? So love yourself, grow, get that knowledge, and apply it. Oh, dope, bro. That's congrats, man. That's huge, man. Baby Hope, Marvin, man, congratulations to you, bro. Man, I'm so excited for you. That is amazing, man. What up, bro? It's been a while. Yeah, man, I appreciate you for tuning in, man. Hey, even if it's been a while, anytime I see your face, anytime you come support, I appreciate it. So doesn't matter how long it's been, I appreciate you now. So yeah, just talking about Wisdom Wednesday. And again, wisdom is applied knowledge. And I like what Sarah said, you know, knowledge without application is null. So what good is that knowledge if you don't apply it and then begin to share and to apply that knowledge so you can be wise? Wisdom Wednesday, man. Let's grow together. Let's get out of the box. Let's think bigger than what we've been thinking. Let's stop all the self-limiting thoughts and actions and words and deeds that we do that's holding us back. And let's just think big, man. 2020, you know, is huge for so many reasons. We're at the start of a new decade. We're at the start of a new year. And my wife and I, we was at home talking the other day, and we was just thinking about, like, the Jetsons, man, thought by 2020 we would be in flying cars and all this stuff. So, for many different reasons, man, this is a big year. 2020 is the future. We are the future. Every day you're living the future. You're also living the past. I don't know if any of you are watching Watchmen and seeing that last episode where, I don't want to spoil it. So, yeah, if you're not watching Watchmen, check it out. It is an amazing thing. But I will talk about this. It reminded me of Neil deGrasse Tyson when he was talking on Logic's album, Everybody. There's a skit on there where Lil Rel and Neil deGrasse Tyson is having a conversation. And in that conversation, Lil Rel had an accident. He's died and gone on, transitioned somewhere. And, you know, Neil deGrasse plays God. He plays God, and he's talking to him. And that skit, man, it brought so much home for me when I first heard it, man. And I still love to go back and listen to the album just for that skit, and because the album is dope as well. But he was talking, and he was saying how you are everybody. You are the future. You are the past. You're living every single person. You are the slave holder and the slave at the same time. You are experiencing every single life in this universe. There's no beginning and no end. You are experiencing things over and over and over again until you have this fullness of, until you've lived every life on this planet. Now, again, that's some deep stuff, a whole nother conversation for maybe another video, or an evening video, or bro study when we get those going again. But if you think about that, it's like, wow, every day we're living the future. Every day we're living the past. Every day we're living the present. So again, apply that knowledge so you can be wise. Wisdom Wednesday, grow. Let's grow, go, show, and shine in 2020. Again, let's grow, go, show, and shine in 2020. I say those two G's are for you. Go and grow. Put things in action so you can grow, so you can flourish. Those two S's are for the haters, the naysayers. Show and shine. Sometimes show people your success. Show people that this is what I'm doing. This is what I've built. It's not a brag. It's not a conceited, arrogant thing when every now and then you just show, hey, look, my hard work is paying off. It's nothing wrong with that. And don't let nobody tell you it is something wrong with that. Ain't nothing wrong with that. And then shine. Shine for the haters, the naysayers. Oh, I knew you weren't going to do this. I knew you weren't going to do that. I knew you weren't strong enough. I knew you weren't wise enough. I knew you didn't have enough money. I knew you didn't have enough education. I knew it wasn't going to last. Shine on the haters. 2020, let's do it big, man. Stop all that little stuff and that little thinking and your old ways of thinking that's just here. I just want to make it. Man, if I could just make it. If I could just get my break. No, man, we ain't trying to make it. We're trying to thrive. We want to go beyond making it. So we do that by being wise, wisdom, applying our knowledge, applying our life experiences to every day, applying everything we've ever been through to now. Right? So let's just do it big, y'all. 2020, let's explode, man. Let's blow up. Let's blow up, man. I'm excited. I'm so excited. Listen, I keep telling y'all, or I keep sharing my other social media platforms. Make sure you're following me, man, on especially my business page on here, Mike James of PNZ Life Coaching, on Instagram, PNZ for Life, on Twitter, PNZ for Life. That's the letter P. A-N-D, the letter Z, F-O-R-L-I-F-E, for life. YouTube, check me out on there, as well as my personal pages, Just Mike James. Just Mike James on Instagram, on Twitter. Check me out, people, because I'm going to start doing more stuff. I've been telling y'all a lot here lately about what direction I want to go in with my business YouTube page. And pretty much it's going to be very similar to podcast, but more to it, more depth than just a podcast, where I want to highlight some businesses that's doing some great things. I want to give people the opportunity to talk about their businesses, do interviews, and just really inspire. You know, I see all the time these networks and platforms and pages that I follow, and I'm like, okay, I can do the same thing in terms of interviewing people. What got you started? This and that and the other. And I don't know how far it's going to go and how far I want to take it, but that's some of the things I'm going to start doing here in 2020 with my YouTube business page. So make sure you're following me on all networks. If you want to know more of the titles and the actual link to all of them, send me a message and I'll send it to you, because I'm driving right now and I can't type them in like I do in some videos. But yeah, Wisdom Wednesday, I just wanted to come on here and share some of that. Y'all know my mission is to share my light, love, and positivity with as many people as I can in the time and space that I have. And I can't do that without you, because I don't know enough people. My circle is not wide enough, but with your help, I can do it. You know, there are people who see some of my videos in other countries. There are people who see my videos all over the United States. So I thank you all for liking, for sharing, for telling people about me. I thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm so grateful. And here it is. I'm continuing campaign. Yes, I'm continuing my I'm proud of you campaign. I got your back campaign. I got your back. I want to see you win. And also, I'm proud of you for what you've already accomplished. I don't care if you're working your job and you feel there's no way out. I'm proud of you for sticking to it, for waking up every day, for going to it, for doing it. Even though you don't like it, I'm proud of you for that. I'm proud of you for starting your own business. Even though right now you think, oh my God, what am I doing? Nobody knows about me. I'm grinding. I'm doing all this stuff and it seems like I'm not getting anything in return. I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you if you're struggling with your relationship, whatever you got going on, but you're still providing for your children, but you're still getting up every day. You're living this life. I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you. Every single one of you. So here we go. Perfect segue to the closing. Murphy's Law. You are somebody. Today you are great. Tomorrow you will be greater, because Ms. Murphy said so and I concur. And know that the universe will align to give you what you want, will, and work for, in that order. And you are what? The five C's. You're capable, competent, confident, conscious, and courageous to do any and everything that you seek to do in this life. You control the breaststroke of that paintbrush. You can paint that canvas all black, all white, all any solid color and start over. You hold the pen. You are the author and finisher of the book of your life. Make some things happen, people. Stop waiting on somebody to help you. Do it. Get up, get out, get something. Make some things happen in this day, in this week, in this month, in this year, in next year. Don't wait on the right time, the perfect time. There's never a perfect time to do anything. Just start moving. And as always, people, know that God loves you. So do I. And I want you to what? Love life, live love, peace. Together, not apart. Y'all take care.